عبده ورسوله. ثم أما بعد، باب زيادة الإيمان ونقصانه. This part or chapter about the increasing of iman and the decreasing of the iman. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال، so أبو هريرة narrated that رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said لا يزني الزاني حين يزني هو مؤمن. So the belief, the one who commit fornication is not doing fornication or zina and he is in a state of iman. ولا يشرب الخمر حين يشرب وهو مؤمن. And he will not drink wine while he's drinking and he's a believer or مؤمن. ولا يسرق حين يسرق وهو مؤمن. And he will not steal when he's stealing or a thief who's doing this and he's in a state of iman. ولا ينتهب نهبة يرفع الناس إليه فيها أبصارهم حتى حين ينتهبها وهو مؤمن. And he will not take anything by force. النهبة أن تأخذ شيء غصب عن الشخص. يعني الصرخة تكون في الخفاء والنهبة تكون نفس الفعل ولكن في العلن. So stealing you steal in secret, but نهبة you take it in public by force, like occupation. You take something by force. And he will not be a true believer or have full iman while he's doing this. زاد مسلم في رواية ولا يغل أحدكم حين يغل وهو مؤمن. فإياكم إياكم. Muslim have extra narration that يغل the, you know, the bounties of a battle. If someone take something not belong to him from the bounties of a battle, if he does so, he will not be a believer also. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم warning us from doing this. وزاد في رواية يعني بخاري ومسلم they have extra in the رواية of narration. والتوبة معروضة بعد. The توبة repentance still open for people to come back to this يعني to Allah سبحانه وتعالى or the state of the iman. But I want to just go through شرح الإمام النووي. الإمام النووي سبحان الله has a beautiful statement about this hadith and I inshallah try to make it quickly for you. فهو يقول وهذا من الألفاظ التي تطلق على نفي الشيء ويراد نفي كماله ويراد نفي كماله. يعني this statement the way in the Arabic language we say it but it doesn't mean that the iman will be negated completely. Meaning the iman is incomplete. The iman is not 100%, is not complete. كما يقال لا علم إلا ما نفع ولا مال إلا الإبل ولا عيش إلا عيش الآخر. The same when you say there is no knowledge except the one that is beneficial to you. And there is no wealth except in camels. But you can have other source of wealth or other gold and so on. ولا عيش إلا عيش الآخرة. And no true life except the life of آخرة. And he's saying why we are doing this. وإنما تأولناه على ما ذكرناه لحديث أبي ذر. Because we have another hadith from Abu Dharr رضي الله عنه. من قال لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة وإن سرق وإن زنى وإن سرق. Whoever say لا إله إلا الله will enter الجنة even if he commit zina or he steals. وحديث عبادة بن صامت الصحيح أنهم بايعوا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم على ألا يسرقوا ولا يزنوا. They made بايعة الصحابة made بايعة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم to not to steal and not to fornicate. And then Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم told them فمن وفى منكم فأجره إلى الله. Whoever fulfill his promise to me, then his reward will be on Allah سبحانه وتعالى. ومن فعل شيئا من ذلك فعوقب في الدنيا فهو كفارته. And whoever commit a sin like this, then he will be punished in dunya. ومن فعل ولم يعاقب فهو إلى الله تعالى. And whoever made this in dunya and he's not punished in dunya, فحسابه على الله سبحانه وتعالى يوم القيامة. It's up to Allah سبحانه وتعالى يوم القيامة. إن شاء عذبه وإن شاء عفى عنه. If Allah سبحانه وتعالى want to release him and يعني forgive him, up to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And then he looked back to the ayah إن الله لا يغفر أن يشرك به ويغفر ما دون ذلك لمن يشاء. Allah سبحانه وتعالى forgive any sin except to make partner with Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وعلى هذا يكون هؤلاء من أصحاب الكبائر. They are the one who commit major sin but not مشركين. Because we have groups of Muslims like Khawarij and Mu'tazila كفروا أصحاب الإيه؟ الكبائر. They said if someone does a major sin, he will not be a Muslim. He will be kafir and so on. So this is what mainly what the Imam Nawawi said رحمه الله. And again, we have to understand that the moment of sin, we're talking now about the moment of sin. The moment of sin is very dangerous because at that time, and this is why they say it's a man is not complete. Okay, it's not kafir but not complete. Why? Because you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala watching you and watching me. So in this moment, and if I'm doing a sin, I will hide myself from all of you. And then I go in a room by myself. But in this moment, do I believe that Allah sees me or not? Even in a closed room? I know, as Muslim, we believe in it by heart, right? But I don't have haya from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I don't, you know, feel that I don't, I know that Allah sees me, and then there's some statement, فَلِمَ جَعَلْتَهُ أَهْوَنَ النَّاظِرِينَ إِلَيْكَ. Why, if you hide from everyone, why you don't hide from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? It's impossible to hide from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they say, some people say, that the moment of sin is a moment of kufr. Not kufr, disbelieving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but you, وَمَا قَدْرُ اللَّهَ قَدْرِ. You don't give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala his true value, the appreciation to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala oversee all of us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has power to destroy all of us, still we disobey him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a critical point, but as ulama, يعني أهل السنة والجماعة believe that it is not kufr, but the iman is not complete. And then they talk about what after the sin. This is why the hadith, وَالتَّوْبَةُ مَعْرُوضَةٌ بَعْدِ, that the door for tawbah is still open. So the moment of sin is bad and has incomplete iman, but the moment you finish, then what you should do, make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the important thing.